You guys already know that trick about the dip your material in the water first before you laser cut it, right? So it doesn't catch on fire and doesn't have charred edges and potentially so it doesn't smell? You guys know that stuff already, right? All right. And you probably know the one about the paper in the water and then you cover your material so you don't get the burnt marks on the top of your material. I know you guys know that. Advanced laser basic model making.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber.
Did you know that my sponsor, PCBWay, has a gift shop on their website? Everything from gift cards and gadgets, such as rulers, to sensor modules. They even have display and output modules, but my favorite, of course, is the tool section. Check out the PCBWay gift shop, link below. All right, if you haven't checked out the basic laser model making video, you should go check that out. Let's start with some basic tools. Ruler, glues, tapes to hold things together while the glue dries, a good pair of calipers so you can measure shit, some straight things, and my favorite, Luer Lock squeeze bottles. Link below on those. Super valuable for placing glue in exactly the right spot. We're gonna make a fancy rounded edge cube. Something a little bit more than just the basic cardboard or foam core. I start off with some sketches about how I think I'm gonna build this model. I'm gonna use some CAD. I'm using Fusion 360 here. And the main reason I'm building this in CAD is so that I can get the dimension of the outside skin with the radiuses. Otherwise, I gotta do some math, et cetera, et cetera. But this does give me all the pieces that I need. And then it gives me the one thing that is a little tougher to calculate with all the radiuses and everything. So I'd build it in CAD. And there it is. I'm gonna apply some materials so we kind of know what it looks like. And that's the piece that I want. In the meantime, let's go cut out that piece of wood and get it ready, so that when we have the actual file, we can laser cut it. Because I don't have a piece of wood that's big enough for that part, because I have to run the grain a certain way. So let's glue two pieces together. We use a little bit of CA, cyanoacrylate, and put a little bit of accelerant on the other piece. I'm gonna butt them up together. I'm gonna get one big piece of wood with the grain going the correct way. I'm using a piece of basswood here, by the way. It cuts on the laser pretty good, and I have a piece of polypropylene on the back side so that it doesn't stick to my work surface. We're gonna add a little more accelerant here just to cure up the glue and then give it a quick sand so that it's nice and flat and we have a minimal gap or seam showing on the model. Now, let's go back to Fusion and let's create the drawing that's going to give us the DXF or the digital file that we can use on the laser cutter to actually cut out. Fusion 360 outputs DXF through a drawing file, or if you're in sketch mode, in this case, we're going to use the output from the drawing file. I'm going to take that base drawing and I'm going to put in a series of lines. These are going to be my kerfs. Where the laser is going to cut and allow us to bend around the corners. I'm going to select them all and set a different power on those than the regular cut, right? I don't want to cut all the way through. I just want to make a kerf like you had a knife blade or something like that, and let the laser cut about halfway through the wood so that I can get a little bit of flex. And this is how my laser is set up. You set the speed of the laser head and then the power of the laser itself. And that's pretty much it. Hit okay, and we'll cut the piece out. So it cuts the inside lines first, which are the little kerf or bendy lines that we're gonna bend around. And then it goes on the outside, cuts the part out, and we have our piece. Now, I didn't put anything protectant on there since it cut the inside, and I'm going to give the outside a sanding, so I'm not too worried about that finish. We're going to soak it so that we can bend it a little bit better. Let's cut the acrylic pieces around which we are going to wrap the wooden skin, and then the end caps. And I'm going to use a piece of EVA craft foam here to cut something for the bottom and that little button for the top. EVA cuts very, very easy. So let's take our piece of wood out that we soaked here in water, and let's wrap it around the pieces to bend everything. You can see where all the little curve cuts are from the laser. And check this out. The piece is too long. I wonder what's going on. I know you woodworkers are laughing your ass off right now at me. We're soon going to discover why that's too long and what error I have made. So I cut it off so I can seam it together. So if the wood is still wet, the cool thing about super glue is that it'll bond even when wet. And paramedics know that. They've been using that in the field for a long time. So we're going to glue that together. Let that set up so we can wrap it around those pieces. And we'll glue those little end cap pieces in there. Put some super glue on the wood. And then we'll wedge our pieces in. We'll use some clamps to keep it all square on the flat sides. And that's how we make that little base cube. Cool. Let's peel the paper off, which I purposely left on the acrylic just to keep it nice and clean. And it's starting to look like a piece of Scandinavian furniture. I love it. All right. Let's glue a bottom onto here after we sanded the bottom flat. Doesn't take much. Put a little accelerant on our EVA foam. Drop that on those drops of super glue, and instantly that is bonded together and we got a little bottom. So this is the top out of acrylic that I made, like a white with a little black button, but I'm not feeling it. Let's do something else. Yeah, there we go. Let's go to black and a circle. So we'll simplify things a little bit. Keep it in that Scandinavian furniture realm. Nope, not going to take the plastic off. You're going to have to wait. Let's put a little finish on the wood. So here's what happened to the wood. You see it shrunk? Yeah. I miscalculated. So basically the wood soaked up all that water and expanded. What I should have done is after I super glued it, just let it dry out and then fit it back in. So we got some finish on there and a little EVA dot on the top that I painted silver. Done. Let's take a look at making this tube with a 30 degree cutoff angle at the end. And we're going to use a new website resource here. It's called templatemaker.nl. And they have this thing built in. Now, the one thing about this website is that they do not account for material thicknesses like MakerCase does in the first video. So you're basically line to line on this stuff. You have to calculate the material thickness. So I pull this into Lightburn, and we're going to recreate some of the stuff that it spits out just because it's not super high resolution. And I also removed the tab off the body skin. So I'm going to make these circles, right? I know that it has a diameter of 50.8 millimeters. The tougher part, of course, is the oval piece here. And I offset that bigger and smaller. And you're going to see why in a second. So a little bit of thought to go into this is required. I'm using some just super cheapo chipboard. This is the back of a notepad. So very affordable material for laser cutting, even a complex object like this. Laser cuts this out super easy, and that is probably the hardest part of the whole thing. Certainly would be tough to cut that by hand with any sort of precision and get it to look nice. We're gonna roll our material here. I'm just using a marker that's rounded and doesn't mar up the inside of the chipboard, and we kind of pre-curve that piece so that when we roll it, it's going to be really nice and smooth and give us the best chance of making something that's as circular as possible. I'm even rolling the tab a little bit just to make things flow really nice. And we're going to glue that together. I'm just using a white PVA glue. It bonds very quickly with this cheap material as it soaks right in and makes a very quick bond. I use some clothespins as they actually have some pretty good surface area, not too much pressure. They don't mar the material. They work wonderful for something like this. I'm going to cut out the two circles that I have for the end. And we're going to glue in the first one, and I put a little bit of glue in there with my Luer Lock squeeze bottle. Now notice I stick the end piece inside the cone and have it come up from the inside of the tube instead of from the outside in, because if you do it from the outside in, it'll start to roll those edges on the inside and you won't get a super clean gap or connection there. And then I push a little bit from the backside again on a piece of plastic. We get a nice smooth finish. And I'm actually going to leave it that way. We're going to put a little glue on the inside, a little bead all the way around, kind of like if you welded it, just for a little bit of extra strength. Now let's cut the ovals that go on the 30-degree cutoff. So we got one oval here that's a little bit smaller than the other. And what we'll do is we'll end up with a little hat section. In this case, I am sanding the edge of the one piece that's going to be exposed just to have it nice and clean. And here I put the inside piece on there and I just kind of eyeball it. You could of course cut a laser line to give you the exact location, but you can eyeball that pretty good. So we'll put a little glue around here and then we're going to pop this in. It's going to be like a little mushroom cap and it's going to fit down inside the inside piece of material will locate everything, and then the outside will sit flush right on top of the outside skin. There we go, it's almost down. Boom, it's down. And you get this pretty nice tube with a 30-degree cutoff on it. Let's make a cone. So we made a cone back in the, like, cardboard basic video, but not as complicated as this one. We're going to use the same templatemaker.nl website. You type in how high you want the cone and how wide, and it calculates everything else. Here again, we're going to remove the tab since we don't need that. We have a better way of making the two pieces come together and a lot more smoother connection. And I already know what the top diameter is because I specified that, and I know what the bottom diameter is. So I'm only using these parts, and actually it didn't even spit out the end pieces. I guess it just assumes everybody's capable of some basic deductive reasoning and math, I guess. Anyway, we're gonna use some Bristol board here. So even thinner material than the chipboard. Again, also very cheap or inexpensive material, but nice high quality white, give you a very nice white appearance model. We're also gonna roll these surfaces that makes the cone ahead of time. So we get that nice, and we have a nice transition from one surface to the other, and we get a nice model. We'll pop a little binder clip on there just to hold that. You want to put it right on the very edge where the transition is from the one surface to the other. We'll put a little bit of glue on there, and then I'll put some tape on my shirt. That's what's going to hold it together, but this Bristol board is pretty nice, and I don't want to mess it up, so I stick it on my shirt so that doesn't stick, but gives me enough bonding power to put the two pieces together. Whoop, a little slippery. Get them nice, and then we'll pop the clothespins on there, and that's going to hold it while it sets up with the white glue. Now with the end caps, This bristle board is pretty thin. You need something, possibly a brush, if you don't have a lure lock bottle like this, or you spread some glue out on a piece of flat surface, and then you can just stick that whole top of the cone in the glue to get glue on that surface. Is another way to do that. And let's do the bottom. Make sure that when you put the end caps on, you put the burnt or the toasty side of the wood on the bristle board on the inside of the model so you don't see it. We use a little bit of tape. We have plenty of strips ready so that we can conform the cone to the circle. Let that dry and peel that off. And we're done. We made a super nice cone. All right. These are all the pieces that we made. It's been a blast. Look for more content soon. This was Advanced Laser Basics. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.